please do remember this, that it has to be fundamentally sound, that the tenets of fundamental analysis, such as growth, earnings, income, debt, all of those things should be perfectly intact. So please do remember that valuations or buying a company that's cheap only makes sense if the company is good. It only makes sense if the company is growing. Only makes sense if it has a good trajectory in towards the future. So by the time we're making this video, we've seen Philippine markets or even US markets drop massively. I've been saying this over and over that there's so much opportunity right now in the midst of the uncertainty. And because of the drop, there are a lot of stocks that have been lower. And I've been getting this prevailing theme and questions that among those that have dropped, which are the ones that are cheaper? Which are the ones that you could get from a discount? That's, I think, a very, very interesting question, because already you're trying to find bargains. You're trying to find opportunities right now, which I think is a very, very good habit, and which I think is one of the secrets of how a lot of people have built wealth over time, that truly, in the midst of uncertainty, chaos, and fear, that's where you can find a lot of opportunities to be able to stack and build wealth. So first things first, of course, one of the easiest things for you to be able to gauge it is look at how big it has dropped as compared to the index. The index is the benchmark, sort of an average for the entire market. I'm talking about discounts and not how bearish or bullish it is from a technical analysis point of view. If the index is probably down 10%, and then the stocks that you're trying to look at is probably down 15-20% already, regardless of how you look at it from a year-to-date perspective or a year-on-year perspective, or from its all-time high also, or from the peak as well, regardless of how you measure it or regardless of how you use it as a benchmark, I think that's one way for you to have a comparison already. However, I want to place this pretext also that the company that you're looking at, that you want to buy also, should be fundamentally sound. It does not make sense to buy something that's majorly low, that has dropped massively as compared to the index, if the company is not worth anything, if the company does not have good fundamentals. So please do remember this, that valuations and buying it cheap is only at the last layer of you wanting something that is already good. So if the company is not actually good, it does not have a great growth story, it's not actually earning, they're actually hit because of what's happening right now, then no matter how cheap it is, then it's something that I may not want to enter into or position into as well. So please do remember that you could use the index as a benchmark on how you can actually compare it. But as you use the index as a benchmark on how you actually compare it, you have to be very, very intentional that what you're buying is a good company that's well run, that's actually also growing as well. You don't want to buy something for the sake that it's very, very low, because what if it doesn't return because the fundamentals are actually bad already? So that's one way for you to be able to gauge it. Another is you could look at the price in proportion to its earnings. So again, one of the things that I look at is the earnings should be increasing. But one ratio that you could look at in that perspective is what you call the price to earnings ratio. Price to earnings ratio basically means that you're looking at the price in reference to the earnings per share. And I like looking at that perspective because it allows you to see if it's actually cheaper based on every earning that you actually got. Some references, or at least some benchmarks that people are putting, is that it has to be below 20 as a benchmark. But another thing that you could actually do is also look at the index. If the index, say, has a PE ratio of 19, and then the stock that you're trying to analyze is a PE ratio of 15, then I think that's something that's generally better, generally cheaper, especially if the company is good, it's fundamentally sound, and it has a good growth trajectory. Again, regardless if you're using PE ratio or you're just comparing it to the index or whatever you're trying to do as a mechanism to analyze that particular stock, please do remember this, that it has to be fundamentally sound, that the tenets of fundamental analysis, such as growth, earnings, income, debt, all of those things should be perfectly intact. So please do remember that valuations or buying a company that's cheap only makes sense if the company is good. It only makes sense if the company is growing. Only makes sense if it has a good trajectory in towards the future. So that's one benchmark that you could use. You could look at 20 times PE ratio. If it's higher than that, then it's still expensive, even if the market is bearish, even if it's down. If it's lower than that, then it gives you a sense that it's generally cheaper. Again, second one is you look at the index. If you compare it to the index, if the PE ratio of the index is 19 and then your PE ratio is 15, that means that the company that you're trying to buy is also something that's actually good. Another way to look at it also is by comparing sectors. meaning if the sector that you're trying to look at or the stock is in. So, for example, if you're looking at the property sector, the stock that you're trying to analyze has a PE ratio of 13, and the entire sector where it's actually in or part of has a PE ratio of, say, 16. So, generally speaking, you could also actually impute that, okay, the PE ratio of this company is 13, all of its competitors and everyone else is a PE ratio of 16. So, it's generally cheaper than the entire sector. So, that's one way for you to actually look at it. One of the methodologies that I've done also in the past is this. You could also compare to the company PE ratio that you're actually looking at. So for example, you could look at Apple. So if you look at the PE ratio of Apple right now, and you compare it to its highest PE ratio in the past versus its lowest PE ratio, is it still closer to the highest PE ratio or is it closer to the lowest portion also? Or another way for you to actually do it is to look at the average. Is it below the average PE ratio over the past year? So that's one way for you to gauge also if it's actually cheap already given a certain period of time. So again, you can do that also for Ayala Corp, you can do that for Ayala Land, you can do that for Globe. That look at the PE ratios, look at it in reference to history, a historical perspective. If you can look at it over a 5-year period, that for example, Globe right now is this PE ratio, and then you try to compare it versus where it was from a 5-year period. What's the highest point? What's the lowest point? If it's very, very far from the highest point, that could be a trigger also for you to actually say that, hey, it's actually cheaper right now. Or if it's very, very close to the lowest point, then that could be also a trigger also for you to actually say that it's actually cheap as well. So those are some methodologies that you could use to actually determine if it's actually cheap. Another one, and just to end this and to put this video to a close, is you can look at it from a perspective of valuations. You compute for its intrinsic value, projected earnings. You could also superimpose whatever the interest rates are, highly connected to that. You compute for the future value of the stock. What that actually means is that if the value is 100 and the stock price is, say, 40, then the stock that you're trying to buy is undervalued. Or if you compute for the fair value and then it comes out as 140, the current price is 100, then that actually means that the stock is overvalued. So those are just some methodologies that you could use. But I just want to say this, that doesn't mean that the stock price is low, the stock price is battered, or there's been a big level of selling that has happened, or people regard that the market is bearish, or there's a recession, or it's scary. That it doesn't mean automatically that the stock is already cheap. Please do remember this. What determines if a stock is cheap is the valuations. What determines if it's cheap is you look at fundamental parameters in order for you to know that it's actually cheap. Please do note that dropping in price does not mean it's cheap. It could be a battered stock. It could go down 10, 15, 20%. But from a fundamental analysis perspective, from a valuation perspective, from a PE ratio perspective, if it's not cheap yet, then you don't have to buy. That's what I like about stock investing, is you don't have to buy. You don't have to come in every time. You only have to come in, you only have to position when it actually makes sense to you, when it's something that is worth coming into based on the parameters that you have set out. I hope that this has helped you. If you guys have any questions with regards to all of this, put it down below and I'll try my best to make videos based on the questions that you guys have sent. And there, if you want to learn more, I've written books about fundamental analysis. It's down below. I also have a seminar about fundamental analysis. It's also down below. It's recorded. You could watch it. Tons of hours of learning and fundamentals that will actually help you. If you stayed up until the end, I hope this video helped you. I hope that this was something that was encouraging to all of you. Hinihingal na ako actually. But I hope that you liked it. And like, share, subscribe. And thank you, little Satoshi, for being a good sport. You were crying a while ago, but thank you for cooperating right now. We already have food also. We're gonna eat lunch in a bit. And thank you. You're the best co-star in this YouTube video. So thank you. I love you. And I hope that you watch this someday and you realize how much your daddy loves you also. Bye, everyone. Trade well, trade strong, trade smart. See you all again soon. God bless you all.